Welcome back. Back to school is more than just shopping for supplies. Experts say now is the best time to get your kids back into their fall routine. And Hanna Kull from Children's Minnesota joins us now. There's a few things to kind of start getting in motion now, right before the first day actually comes. And one of those is getting sleep schedule back on track.
Yes, so important that kids get their required amount of sleep. For preschool kids, we want to make sure that they're getting about 10 to 13 hours of sleep. For school age kids, about 9 to 11. And for those teenagers, about 8 to 10 hours. And about now is the time when you want to start kind of putting them to bed a little bit earlier, about 15 minutes a night, and then waking them up in the morning about 15 minutes earlier. Just makes back to school better for everybody.
Good luck with that, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Good luck getting everyone to go to bed earlier. And then once you kind of get back into that school routine, healthy diet, you know, preventing that come home and reach for the cookies in the fridge kind of thing. What tips do you have for that?
Exactly. So summertime is a great time to kind of empower kids to make healthy choices. As parents, we all want our kids to eat healthy. And the summertime with vegetable gardens and farmers markets is a great time for kids to learn about healthy choices. They can be part of shopping, they can be part of meal prep. And then once they actually get back to school, I think it's really important that they eat breakfast. For a lot of kids, they just don't want to eat breakfast, they're not hungry, right. But they have to eat something. So something quick, peanut butter toast, a hard-boiled egg, smoothie. And then as far as lunches go, if they're gonna eat at school, talking to your kids about, you know, what's healthy and what's not as far as the choices at school. And a great way to show them that is when you're out to eat, kind of looking at choices and making healthy choices yourself. And then I always think it's important, if you can pack your kids' lunch. Mm-hmm. That way you know what they're eating at school and you can also get some fruits and vegetables in. And then for when they get home from school, having kind of, like you said, easy grab and go things in the fridge, like cut up fruits and vegetables, string cheese, yogurt, so that they can just quick grab something instead of snacking on junk when they get home.
I've seen some folks, they have like the snack drawer where like, you know, little baggies of carrots and dip or whatever. That's such a good idea.
Absolutely.
And a lot of kids are excited to get back to school, but maybe some aren't. Some a little anxious, a little nervous. Yeah. How do we deal with that?
Yeah, that's a really common thing for most kids to be just kind of scared or anxious or kind of back to school blues. And if your child's starting a new school this year, it might be a good idea to just get like a tour of the building. That way they can acclimate themselves to the school, meet the teacher if you can. That way they kind of know what to expect on the first day. And if your child does struggle with anxiety, kind of talking them through what exactly is scaring them, getting to the bottom of it and talking it over with them. And then once you've talked about it, not dwelling on it. And for more, you know, kind of serious situations like bullying, having an action plan set up.
So what is an action plan when you, when you're talking to your kids about bullying, what do you say to them if this happens to you, if you see this happening in both of those scenarios, what do you do?
Yeah, so I think it's important to tell kids that they need to speak up. If they see or hear bullying going on, that it's okay to say something to a parent or a teacher, and that, you know, if bullying was an issue last year, making sure that they know that it's going to go up. You know, we're going to talk with the teacher, we're going to talk with the principal and kind of get to the bottom of this.
And that's, it kind of goes both for in-person stuff and on social media too.
Right.
Right?
Right. Absolutely.
Do you handle those two kind of things the same?
Absolutely. I think it's important, just, you know, a lot of kids on social media are kind of quiet about things. They kind of keep it to themselves, but making sure that they're letting you know, if it's happening on social media, because that's huge nowadays where it's happening.
So just kind of keeping that dialogue open. And
yeah, they know they can come to you and that it's okay to speak up about it.
Excellent. Thank you, Hannah, for being here.